Arena here in Nagano, Japan, to our continuing coverage of the 2002 World Figure Skating Championships presented by Expedia.com. Hi again, everybody. Terry Gannon back with you. We go from ice dancing to the ladies' short program now, and all the major players are here in Nagano except for one. But we'll forgive her, the 16-year-old from Great Neck, New York, Sarah Hughes, the Olympic gold medalist, the parades, the appearances, getting reacquainted with her high school classmates, so she is not here in Nagano. But, Dick Button, that means we get to watch Michelle Kwan take on Irina Slutskaya once again. Kwan has beaten the Russian the last three times they've met at Worlds, but Michelle has not beaten Irina since the 2001 World Championships.
Well, what we've got here, to cut to the quick, is a humdinger of a competition. Now, I got to tell you, in the light of the problems that erupted in Salt Lake, we have to take a look at the judging panel. And what do we see here? First of all, there's no North American, no U.S. or North American judge. That's the luck of the draw. But six of the remaining judges have all been affiliated with each other, either through the Soviet Union or the so-called Eastern Bloc. So look, one final point is, where does that leave us? If either skater skates badly, the judging will be very easy. If both skaters skate well, we'll have to see if the panel can be objective. What that comes down to is that you cannot win these titles by scrimping ahead. You've got to be leaps and bounds ahead of your competitor, and that way you'll be secure in your medal.
And there's definitely some intrigue here in Nagano. We turn to Peggy Fleming right now, another major player here, Sasha Cohen, who finished behind Michelle Kwan at the National Championships, but at Nationals she did beat the eventual Olympic gold medalist, Sarah Hughes.
Well, Sasha is 17 years old, and she missed most of the major international competitions last year because of a very serious back injury. She placed ahead of the new Olympic champion, Sarah Hughes, at our national championship, and then she went on to the Olympic Games and placed fourth, her very first major international competition of the season. And now she's here at the World Championships, her first, and she could be the spoiler in this event and do what Sarah Hughes did at the Olympic Games.
And as always, the short program, all about the eight required elements. There are specific deductions for each mistake. For example, a 1/10 deduction for touching a hand down or a foot down during a jump, a stumble on a jump, up to 5/10 deduction for the omission of any of the elements.
Elena Kriashenko.
Unlike the Olympics, there are three phases to the competition for the ladies here at the World Championships. The qualifying round, which was worth 20%, short program 30%, the free skate 50%. And on the ice, from Ukraine, Yelena Liashenko. Years of age, from Kiev. She was fourth in her qualifying group, Group B.
She's opening with a triple lutz. Watch this very long entry into this lutz jump. She takes her time.
They call that telegraphing.
But she did it very well.
It's a specific no-no among the rules and the recommendations to the judges not to telegraph, but to use steps and individual movements and creative entrances.
A little trouble on that landing of the triple flip.
Short program, 2 minutes and 40 seconds in length. Yelena recorded most of her top international results many years ago. She was sixth at the World Championships in 94, third at the Europeans in 1995, but a bit of a drought since then. She was eighth at Worlds last year.
Is supposed to go from one end of the ice to the other.
And the footwork wasn't very imaginative or very creative or unusual. It wasn't done with great speed.
I think she looks relieved that that's over. I mean, mm-hmm. there's so much tension in this short program because those eight required elements are so important.
Saw her recently come in ninth in Lausanne at the European Championships, 14th at the Olympics, Yelena Lyashenko.
Yeah, and here is a look at that very long entry into this combination jump. You're supposed to have the choreography blend into these moves, but she pulls it off with a beautiful triple lutz double toe.
Yelena with her coach, Marina Amerkinova. And the first set of marks. That'll be two sets, as always. The first for required elements here in the short program. How well they perform. The eight required elements, five twos, five threes.
Well, those marks are so close that you cannot even question the fact that the judges all thought exactly the same thing.
Although consistency isn't exactly what we're looking for here.
Not by no means, because then you feel, the judge feels they have to judge the way their friends do. And that's one of the difficulties in policing this.
Presentation marks 5.2 up to 5.6 for Yelena Lyashenko from the Ukraine. When we come back, the teenager from Massachusetts, Jenny Kirk, will take the ice. A new pair of boots. She just found out a couple of weeks ago that she was going to skate at the World Championships, and she changed coaches. She's always been coached by Evie and Mary Scottfield. Now it's Richard Callahan.
Well, I think everybody needs a change once in a while, and it wasn't any one big thing. You know, I love Evie and Mary, and I definitely couldn't be where I am right now without them. But I'm graduating high school in June, so I knew this summer I wanted to kind of see where my life would take me, if I was going to devote the rest of the next 4 years to school or to skating or what I was going to do. And I really decided that if I was going to go all the way in my skating, I needed a change, and I needed kind of a training environment that would really push me. So I decided to look around for another coach.
Presented by Expedia.com, the short program worth 30%. Jenny Kirk from the U.S. on the ice, the 17-year-old from Newton, Massachusetts. She came in fourth in her qualifying group, which was qualifying group A, along with Michelle Kwan, Fumie Suguri, and others.
She gets good energy and spark when she's performing. Opening with a triple lutz, double toe combination. That'll be like a .4 deduction.
Whatever it is, it's a disaster if you're looking to really move ahead. She's an elegant skater, good line. Ah, and it's, now you could see how she leaned on that, how the foot, when she tapped it in, was way over on the side. Just not a good position to take off a toe jump from. Pretty spiral, though.
Well, she just found out less than 2 weeks ago that she was going to be a competitor here at the Worlds, her very first World Championship, because of Sarah Hughes not coming to this championship.
And Angela Nikodinov, who was the first alternate, she has a dislocated shoulder.
Very dangerous forward outside edge. A little bit of a twist going into the air on that. A good layback, but with the quality of laybacks in ice skating right now, I think she'll have to stretch that one even further.
She won her first major international title at the Four Continents Championship in January, but she thought her competitive season was over, as Peggy said. That's caused a few problems, Peggy.
Yes, and she's also breaking in new skates. She just found out, you know, less than 2 weeks ago that she was going to be skating here, and she was starting to break in new boots, and now she's got all these blisters. She's, like, amazing. She can skate so well.
Yeah, she thought it was okay to break in some new boots because her season was over. Not what she wanted.
Well, it was just unfortunate. It was a mediocre performance for her. She can do a lot better than that. She's an elegant skater, and I think she has a lot of potential. This was clearly not her day or her moment.
And this was the opening problem that she had in this program, this triple Lutz. She taps in and is turning fine in the air. It's almost like she gave up on that landing. And this is our Strow Motion brought to you by Chevy. A look at the triple flip that she had problems with. Watch her tap in here. Right there, she puts her foot into the ice and catapults herself up in the air. She's kind of leaning in the air, and her foot is wrapped around for that landing, and she just could not pull that landing off.
That's her new coach, Richard Callahan. Look at Jenny holding that left hip. She looked like she was in some pain as she left the ice. We're set now for required elements, 3.6.
Well, those marks, unfortunately, they're almost vicious. You know, they're so disappointing for one in their very first world championship, particularly when they're as good a skater as Jenny is. But, you know, something, she can rise above this.
And now the presentation marks 4.7 up to 5.3 for the 2000 World Junior Champion. Not a good experience so far, the first Senior Worlds for Jenny Kirk. The final group on the ice warming up for the ladies' short program, including Michelle Kwan, the four-time world champion. She's won three in a row, but now she wants number five overall here in Nagano. And how about the 17-year-old from Laguna Niguel, California, Sasha Cohen, who created quite a stir at the Olympics, just missing the podium. This is her first trip to the Senior World Championships. And, of course, Irina Slutskaya, the 23-year-old from Moscow. She's won four medals at Worlds in her career, but now she wants the gold medal. A group of top contenders about to skate in the short program next. Tips presented by Expedia.com continue now. The ladies' short program, the top group of contenders with Michelle Kwan on the ice warming up, the Olympic bronze medalist. She got the silver, of course, in Nagano, this city. Not in this arena, though. It was over at White Rink. Here she is, having won her qualifying group, and Irina Slutskaya, her major rival since 1994, the Olympic silver medalist, the 23-year-old from Moscow, has four medals in her career at Worlds, but never the gold medal. And what about the 17-year-old from Laguna Niguel, California, Sasha Cohen, who created a major stir at the Olympics. She was in third place after the short program there, but she dropped to fourth place, just missing the podium. But for Michelle Kwan, you can't minimize how devastating her two Olympic disappointments have been, but she certainly has learned to be philosophical about those.
Most of the fan mail have played a big impact in my life. I mean, what they say, encouraging me, their support, and just saying, you know, regardless of what happens, we still love you. And I feel like sometimes the fans are part of my family, because that's what I feel with my family, that it doesn't matter. I mean, for them, it's like, oh, you win, you lose, it doesn't matter, you know? You're Michelle, give me a hug, you know? It's very nice.
And Peggy, it is the same Michelle Kwan. When you talk to her around, this is what she does. She competes.
She really does. And she really wants to, you know, let that get in the past and move on with her life. And she really does refuse to let that all drag her down. She just pushes on.
Dick, it must have been difficult after the loss in Salt Lake to get back on the ice and train for Worlds.
I have great sympathy for them, because number one, you build to such a peak for the Olympic Games that it's got to be a letdown afterwards, and it takes time.
Then we take a look at the order in which they will skate here in this final group in the ladies' short program. Michelle Kwan is before Sasha Cohen, and then Irina Slutskaya is the last to skate in this group. Up first in this final group, Yulia Sebastian from Hungary, 20 years of age. She came in eighth at the Olympics. She's in sixth after the short program.
She has wonderful spring in her jumps.
She was in qualifying Group A with Kwan and Suguri. She came in third, right behind Fumie Suguri.
Opening with a triple flip. Very nice. Good, steady landing.
Magnificent spring in that jump. He's a very steady skater. There doesn't seem to be great excess movement. A little bit of arm flailing here.
Now watch the height that she gets in this triple up.
High and low.
High and low all at the same time.
The heights and the depths.
It's going to be a 0.4 deduction for an error like that.
There's a security to her edges. It's very refreshing. You don't feel nervous that she's going to miss, even if she does, or that she's insecure.
Circular footwork. Good energy and speed. Very interesting.
She's a pleasant skater. Very enjoyable to watch. She made the final group at the 2000 Worlds when she came in seventh. Last year, though, she came in 18th at the World Championships. Yulia Sebastian from Hungary.
And here's a look at the problem she had on the triple lutz. Watch as she taps in right here. She doesn't get the usual height in the jump. And watch her free leg wrapped around her landing leg, and she couldn't pull it out for a steady landing.
That's Nina Petrenko, Victor's wife, on the left side of your screen. She did the choreography for Yulia Sebastian. First set of marks for required elements. There they are, 4.6 up to 5.2. Oh, there's quite a variation there if you see your 4.6 as the low mark and 5.2 as the top.
4.8.
Obviously reflecting the mistakes that were.
Marks for presentation.
And the second set now for presentation. 5.2 up to 5.6 for Yulia Sebastian, a 20-year-old student at the University of Commerce and Economics in Hungary.
5.2, 5.5, 5.6, 5.4. Thank you.
Coming up next, Fumie Suguri from Yokohama, Japan. She'll have the hometown crowd on her side, but recently, Sarah Hughes, who's now resting back at home after a victory in Salt Lake, she got together with Peggy Fleming to demonstrate an ice move in figure skating.
You know, a lot of people have asked me after the 68 Olympics of how I did my layback spin. And it's a really difficult spin because you're in this layback position. You're actually looking at the ceiling as you're spinning around. And it's a really strange feeling, but you do get used to it. And Sarah Hughes here has one of the classic layback spins. And she does it by squaring off her hips and arching straight back and getting this wonderful line. She doesn't move from side to side. Now, Sarah, do you think you could show us one? It's easy enough to do a layback with your free leg down low, as Sarah's demonstrating. But watch Sarah as she has a beautiful turned-out position. And turned-out means that the free leg and foot must be as flat and parallel to the ice as possible. Sarah, that was absolutely beautiful. You know, it takes years and years of practice to perfect a spin like this. And I think you've got it.
Tomorrow night, Michelle Kwan continues pursuit of her fifth world championship in the ladies' free skate, starting at 8 o'clock Eastern on ABC Sports. In addition to the ladies, we'll see the free dance as well. Tomorrow night on ABC, the 2002 World Figure Skating Championships presented by Expedia.com.
The ladies' short program underway here at the World Figure Skating Championships presented by Expedia.com. On the ice right now, in her home country, the 21-year-old from Yokohama, Japan, Fumie Suguri. She came in fifth in Salt Lake City.
She's skating to Ave Maria.
Music of great skating stars like Barbara Ann Scott of Canada and Peggy Fleming of the United States.
Well, she chose this music because the Olympic year is about peace, and she wanted the music to express peace.
Well, let's hope she's at peace with this opening triple lutz. Beautiful, beautiful move.
I love her soft landings. She really uses her knees very well. Very nice triple flip, very soft. A lot of spring to the jump.
In a nice position in her layback. This, watch first the height and now the drop and the shape of the back, the stretch of the free leg. That's a beautiful position.
The spiral could be a little better if she arched her back more.
Programmed by Lori Nickel. Coached by Nobuo Sato, Yuka Sato's father. Yuka Sato, the 94 world champion.
Spin, great speed, good positions,
and a wonderful back scratch spin, one of the few that we've seen.
Great performance.
How much fun is that at home, huh?
That's wonderful, wonderful to see. She just gave so much emotion and ease with all of these elements in this short program. It was a great, great number for her.
Here come the flowers. 21-year-old Fumie Suguri of Japan.
You always feel comfortable with Fumi skating. Look at this triple lutz. Wonderful height on it and a beautiful swing back into the double toe loop. She makes you feel easy. Look at the height there. Now watch the position in this back sit spin. A wonderful straight back, pointed feet, pointed legs. I mean, that's terrific.
Still acknowledging the crowd here. Fumie Suguri finally sitting down to wait for her marks now. The first set for required elements coming her way. She is from Yokohama, not far from Tokyo. There they are. What about the 5-3?
I think what you have to do is consider the fact that she's put her in second place, whereas every other judge has them in first place at this point, if one considers the presentation marks, which are just coming up now.
So we consider the presentation marks 5.5 up to 5.8, the high mark.
But you see, there's the answer right there, the fact that the Russian judge put her in second place. The highness or lowness of the mark is less important than that ordinal, and I think uncalled for in this case.
Still to skate here in the ladies' short program, Arina Slutskaya of Russia. She'll be the last one to skate. Sasha Cohen also still to come, but up next, It's Michelle Kwan trying to win her third world title in a row, her fifth overall next. Through her two Olympic disappointments, she's kept a unique perspective on who she is and what's important in life. And that's a large part of why she's right here. She's a skater. She competes. And that's what she wants to do here at the World Championships, going after World Championship number 5, Michelle Kwan.
Well, she definitely loves the challenge of competition and pushing herself all the time.
That. Now, you see, something's happening that she's just unable to sustain the pressure of these events. I think that will cost her dearly in this competition.
In her qualifying round, she completed her first clean triple-triple since last year's Worlds.
Backspin, very unusual. This has to be rather haunting for her to come back here to Nagano and skate the same number she skated in 1998 at the Olympic Games.
Different arena. It was over at White Ring, which is now a gym, but the same city.
Jump that she fell on in the long program at the Olympic Games, this triple flip. But not here. Very nicely done.
Now look at the height of her back here. Good position in this back sit-spin. That's classic.
Position of great arch in her back and extraordinary extension.
She performs with such gentle edges, such soft moves. It's so ladylike. The flow is just so encouraging to see.
A wonderful program all the way through with one exception. And that's been the story so many times. There has been one exception. But it certainly is a beautiful, beautiful performance. She's trying to tie Carol Heiss for the most ladies' world titles by a U.S. skater with 5. Michelle Kwan.
And this was a very critical mistake she made in this program, the triple lutz. She taps in very tight in the air, but she's leaning back a little bit and her free leg swung around and could not make a solid landing. But then she stepped and finished the double toe. But that will cost her probably a 0.3 deduction. But this is extraordinary. And her signature move, these beautiful edges she does and the extension and the joy in her face and throughout her entire body. This is a great move.
As your father, Danny, we've got used to seeing him in the Kiss and Cry, but he's only about 15 feet from the Kiss and Cry. He's been here. He's been near the rink boards, encouraging her. U.S. team leaders, along with Michelle, John Jackson, Debbie Curry. Now the first set for required elements.
Oh, wow. And look at that, a 5-2, a 5-3.
5-3.
That's really, really tough.
5-3.
But they're all very consistently low, so...
And now the second set for presentation, which always go up for Michelle Kwan, and they do considerably.
But they're still 5'7s and 5'8s.
Extremely disappointing marks
terms of the first set. The Russian judge, though, put Michelle Kwan in first place so far. But she is overall in second. So far, it's Fumie Suguri with the lead over Michelle Kwan and Yelena Lyashenko. And on the ice is Yoshie Onda from Japan, 19 years of age, from Nagoya. She came in 17th at the Olympics in Salt Lake City. And she again tried her triple axel in the qualifying round, but two-footed it.
She's a very athletic skater, a lot of energy. She's opening with this triple lutz, double toe. Like she's really attacking this program.
Well, that was sort of a not stretched back move with an arm swing that was very difficult, but her athleticism is fine. Her artistry, for example, in this layback could be much better. She's a powerful skater.
Throws the choreography away. She doesn't give it any importance.
And this spiral sequence, I think, very weak when we've seen some of the brilliant spirals elsewhere among the ladies. That's just not acceptable, that position. Interesting that she places that move over so close to the side, but all you can see is the Chevy advertisement.
Those folks will be happy.
Very.
Straight line footwork. She does have speed going for her, though.
There's speed, strength, athletic ability, and not very much grace. That hurts her. This a forward axel, double axel. Excellent spring to it.
Very nice.
Wonderful space before the landing.
Well, the axel is her favorite jump, and that's what she is going to attempt in the long program, is a triple axel.
Good energy and good speed. Almost at the end.
Got that fist pump down, though, I'll say that. Yeah. Yoshie Onda, 19 years of age, twice the bronze medalist at the Four Continents Championship. Came in 12th a couple of years ago at the World Championships.
And this is a wonderful example of the spring that she gets in her jumps, this triple lutz. Was very high, very tight in the air, and very controlled right into the double toe. Very solid opening. And here is the look at the triple flip that she did. Good height again, and a little bit uncontrolled on the landing, but she did land it solid, and that will be counted very, very highly.
She hasn't stopped smiling since she left the ice.
Well, she should be very proud of that performance.
She's a very peeling personality.
She had a ball out there in the short program. Required element marks, 5.4 to 5.6.
And those are very acceptable marks. Very consistent, very high, and she should be happy with that.
And what about the presentation marks now?
Well, they're not quite as good. They drop down a bit. That's because she hasn't yet learned to soften up some of those angular moves and develop a little more elegance. But she's a very exciting athlete.
Mostly third places from the judges, and she is in third overall behind Michelle Kwan.
5-3, 5-4.
Up next, it's Sasha Cohen, who certainly made a splash in Salt Lake City, handing President Bush her cell phone, and then coming in fourth, she definitely left her mark at the Olympics.
I don't quite think of myself as a celebrity, quote-unquote, like Julia Roberts or Britney Spears, but I do see myself as, you know, one of the top figure skaters, and with that comes attention. And I feel like a lot of the world knows me now, especially after the Olympics, because a lot of people were watching the ladies long. It's nice to have shared my skating with the whole world, but it also is hard sometimes when you just want to go out with your friends and you have a lot of people recognize you.
Great. Michelle, before the short program, did you feel settled?
You know, in the warm-up, I felt really settled. I didn't have such a good morning practice, but I felt pretty settled tonight.
Well, you're your own coach, so now what are you telling yourself going into the free program?
Take one thing at a time. It wasn't a huge mistake, but any mistake in the short program is huge, so just have to take one thing at a time in the long program.
Okay, well, thank you, and good luck in the free.
Thank you.
Back here at the World Figure Skating Championships, presented by Expedia.com, Terry Gannon along with Dick Button, Peggy Fleming, Peter Carruthers along as well. Michelle Kwan struggled a bit in her short program. She is behind Fumie Suguri right now in the standings as Sasha Cohen, the 17-year-old from California, takes the ice. She was in qualifying group B. She came in second right behind Slutskaya, who is still to skate.
And she's a classically styled ballerina. Look at the back, the stretch of it, the arch of it. This triple Lutz. Just exquisite landing positions. The stretch of the leg. Now watch the reach of the free leg as she taps into this flip.
She has a very determined look on her face when she makes these landings.
She needed it there. Her spirals are without peer.
Ever when she skates. You know, this program could come across in a real fragile because it's very lyrical, very gentle kind of music, but she adds so much energy and command to this program. It's wonderful.
Ah, right there. There's that dangerous double axel, that forward edge. It can get you at any time, in any place. It's the most dangerous edge in skating. Look at these split jumps.
Final combination spin. Great speed. Wonderful number.
You know, what we've seen is something really very interesting. Michelle has made a major error, and now Sasha has made a major error. The door was open so wide there. Fumi Suguri has stepped into it. The question is now, what will happen with Irina Slutskaya? I mean, this is a real mix-up at this point.
The home team with the lead right now, Fumi Suguri. We'll see what happens in terms of the marks for Sasha Cohen.
Now look at the absolute exquisite movement here in this triple Lutz. Watch it. Look at the free leg, how straight it is, the point in, the position of the body. Everything is just wonderful. The back on the landing. I mean, my gosh, that's textbook if there ever was one.
phenomenal. But here on this double axel, it's the forward edge that's always the danger point. Watch it. Right there. You see it step up into the air. She points her feet beautifully, but cannot hold that landing, is not checking her right shoulder back. And that would have stopped the rotation.
5-2, 5-3.
Sasha with John Nix, her coach. The first set for required elements. Look at those marks in the 5.0 from the Russian judge, the Swedish judge.
Well, it's phenomenal that those marks are that low, because the rest of it is 100%.
Remember, the Russian judge is the one that put Michelle Kwan in first place, the only one.
And here we find the presentation marks. Look at that.
And now the judge's placements. The Russian judge put Sasha Cohen in sixth. She's in fourth overall.
I love
and
it.
He's not happy about it.
No, and he's letting you know he knows exactly what he wants.
Wow. Getting ready to skate next, the final competitor in the ladies' short program, Arina Slutskaya. You know, the Olympics were full of controversies, including a protest filed by the Russian Federation after she placed second in the ladies' event.
It's judges. I'm skating, they're judging. I can't go and fight with them, right? But I really want to ask those judges who give me 5.6 and give me fourth place. I want to go and ask him or her, I don't know who is it, ask about, for what? For what? Where's my, like, huge mistake? Where is it? Show me, please. Okay, I have, like, small deduction, maybe, like, one, not like four marks, like, what they're doing, but I really want to ask, you know, because I'm so interesting. I think lots of people are interested.
She's a very powerful jumper.
That was done with ease.
And it's a difficult combination because it is a triple lutz, double loop. More difficult than the big double toe at the end. Coming up is this triple flip. She fell on this jump at the Europeans, and she had trouble on it on the long program at the Olympics. Not here, very solid. Good flowing edge out of it.
This layback really isn't a layback. It's more of a catch foot layback, which is interesting variation. One foot footwork right here. She doesn't change from foot to foot. Makes it a little more difficult. Good speed. These spirals and the spiral sequence just are not up to some of the other skaters. That's a better position. Lay back.
And her signature moves, these Veelman spins.
Nice that she does them in both feet. And that was a very, very strong and energetic performance. I think one of the better ones that I've ever seen her do. Well, you know how
very athletic skater. A lot of energy. This triple lutz.